Welcome to a short Dewesoft video. We will introduce the Dewesoft sequencer by using the balloon tester. For an uninvolved person, this is just a balloon. But what can we do with it? We can monitor the pressure curve during inflation. We can pop it. We can compare balloons. Or we can also check the elasticity of the material before and after 1000 inflation cycles. So there are lots of tests you can do. But do you want to do them all manually? The Dewesoft sequencer is an easy way to control Dewesoft and let procedures run automatically for testing purposes. It has a very intuitive user interface, like a flowchart. You can simply add blocks and queries and draw lines between them. After starting, a control bar appears on top, which will guide you. For demonstration, we built a small device called the balloon tester. The air balloon is placed on the nozzle. The pumps are for inflation. We have one valve for air inlet and one valve for outlet. A sensor measures the pressure inside of the balloon. So the air will flow like this. Let's look at the Dewesoft setup. The pressure sensor is full bridge circuit and connected to a series STGM module. The sync port was switched to digital out. Pump inlet and outlet valve can be accessed via control channels now. The blue line in the recorder shows the pressure and the yellow one the average pressure. One of the major applications is the durability test. We want to inflate the balloon until Pmax, hold the pressure for a certain time, deflate to Pmin, hold, and inflate again. This we repeat 1000 times. We can split that into blocks. Inflation, idle mode, and deflation. At the beginning of the sequence, we have initialization blocks, like load setup, set instruments, and so on. You can use if conditions to check for variable values and create loops. After the balloon is inflated, the pressure will be held, and deflation process starts until P reaches Pmin. Then we will wait again. We created custom blocks for simplification. If you double click on them, you see that they contain several functions. For each state we have one. Go back to the main sequence. The remaining blocks are delays and incrementing the cycle counter. Start the sequence with the play button. Notice the audio-guided instructions.
Please manually inflate balloon to medium size.
Switch on pump and inlet valve to get a nice starting pressure. This is a precondition for running the test. After we have done that, we can enter our file informations, like balloon type, size, and color. But more important, we made the pressure levels configurable. Let's start the test. The second example we want to show is a basic control loop. We want to keep the pressure inside the balloon constant. In reality, we would have to define a tolerance band. Control possibilities are inlet and outlet valve. Assume the pressure is increasing. When reaching the tolerance band, we open the outlet valve. the pressure normalizes again. Leakage causes loss of pressure. We have to open the inlet valve and activate the pump. Now the pressure is held constant at 50 millibar. When you press the balloon, the pressure increases and the outlet valve opens. Release it and the pressure drops. Inlet valve opens and pump starts again. How does the sequence look like? Basically, it consists of three stages, but it's best explained with the debug function. In debug mode, you can walk through the sequence step by step. Step over or just let it run. Now you can see the sequencer in operation. When inflating, the third condition branch is active. When the pressure is okay, it moves through the first branch, the idle mode. During pressing the balloon, the second if condition becomes true, it's deflating. Of course, this cannot be compared with the real PID control, which is able to cope with all different kinds of interferences. Let's have a look at some applications. You can build loops for endurance testing, as well as more complex branches. For example, if you want to perform an engine test in a climate chamber for different temperatures. The voice-guided assistance helps when working in a vehicle and you can't look at the display during measurement. Thanks for watching, and I hope you gained some knowledge about balloons and the Dewesoft sequencer.